hopefully that was fun for everybody. We jumped in, we easily added a CTA to every single blog post that we're ever going to write. We can always go back in and edit that in that same single post template, but we don't have to remember to add that back in there. So that's a really efficient way to kind of make a bigger impact on your site and what kind of results it can drive for you. Now, not everybody needs a donation button or a call to action CTA or something. Some people just create websites to get their viewers or their audience to digest their content, whether it's written content or some kind of art that you're working on or whatever. Maybe you just want more exposure. So we're going to take a different use case. We're going to jump back into a band, my band. We're going to look at it and we're going to say, how do I get more plays for, say, a new song that maybe came out? You could do this with video content. You can do it with, again, a featured post that you really want to highlight or whatever. The idea is you just want more people to see a specific piece of content that you have. I'm going to shrink my face and we're going to look at this. We're in the editor. The approach we're going to take for this is going for the header specifically. And the header, again, is a template part. So we're going to open site menu. We're going to go down to template parts. And we're going to choose header linear, which is what I currently have active on the site. This is pretty basic. This is what I have in place right now. So Spotify is what I'm going to use for my embed for my song here. Usually you can just paste the Spotify link from the song or the track or whatever, and it will embed magically in WordPress. There's also a Spotify block. In this case, I'm going to use a smaller version of the player. So I actually got the embed code on a different window that you can't see that I'm going to use. What I'm going to look at again is just how my blocks are structured over here. So we have everything in one row right now. When I look at this row, I could maybe try to squeeze that song in the middle, but that might make it a little too busy or crowded. I think what I want to do in this case, just start with a group, and then I'm going to click to add a new block. And I think I'm going to add a new row just for the player, just hopefully so it doesn't cause any styling issues or anything. So I'm going to add that row. I'm going to add a new block. And I'm going to choose, this is custom HTML. So I'm going to copy that code again. That's on a different screen you can't see. But I'm just going to paste it in here. And we're going to preview it. So that's what it looks like here. I tested this before and it actually goes full width on the page itself. So this is something, again, full site editing is new. This is the first release. It's going to be iterated on. It needs to be kind of played around with all these different blocks. So as you play with it, remember to check your work. Remember to just see what it looks like before you save and walk away from your site or whatever. It's not like it's the end of the world, but it takes a little bit of tweaking and getting used to, and there's lots of improvements and lots of great ideas coming that'll be worked on too. So right now, I'm gonna just shrink this down real quick and see what it might look like and how things stack. And I think that's probably fine. So I'm gonna go ahead and save it. And then we can go to the site in the front end and just see how it looks. So cool. So I have that player there now. It gave my header a little bit of space. It pushed my content down, which is kind of expected, but I have that front and center. I might want to go back later and play with maybe adding like a headline here, new single or whatever. But let's see, if I go to a different page, I've got that header, or I've got that player in place again. And I haven't gone through every template on the site yet, so it's not going to look perfect, but there's your use case for using it.